Amen. Yeah, that's my pastor, you know. So as your worship leader for this afternoon, it is indeed my pleasure to welcome you to the Memorial Moravian Church. And for those in our viewing audience, we wish you a warm welcome as well. The formal welcome will come shortly from our president. But at this time, as we will begin our service, I will call on Ms. Cheryl Edwards, a member of the best class to ever leave the Charlotte Amalia High School, the class of 1986, to come and open us in prayer. Y'all agree, right? Amen.
Good afternoon. That is going to start a little bit of issues, but can we all rise in the presence of God? This afternoon, we came in the honor of 100 years of celebration of education. We come thanking God for the different elevations of people within the community of the Charlotte Amalia High School. So, Father God, this afternoon, we just say thank you. We thank you for the teachers. We thank you for the counselors. We thank you for the principals, vice principals, Lord God. Father God, we thank you for everyone, Lord God, who has been impacted in some way or form by this school. We thank you, Lord God, that excellence is what we stand for. And when we stand for excellence, Lord God, you're in the midst. We thank you for the ones who have gone ahead that have done so much for us. We lost one in particular this week, Lord God, and what she has done for this community has gone beyond. We thank you, Lord God, for developing principals. We thank you, Lord God, for governors. We thank you, Lord God, for doctors and lawyers, Lord God. We thank you for engineers, Lord God. We thank you for scientists, Lord God. We thank you, Lord God, that you have everyone in this community, Lord God, who have touched somehow, some way, Charlotte Amalia High School. We ask, Lord God, that we only not concentrate on the past, but Lord God, we thank you for the teachers who are now there. We ask that you encourage them. We ask that you press forward in them, Lord God, in a way that they have never seen. Lord God, continue to guide their thoughts. Continue to guide their feet. Lord God, continue, Lord God, to pour out the love that you have poured into them, into our students, Lord God, that we will continue to see the excellence that we stand for, God. Lord God, you said that if we concentrate on you and we put everything that we do in you, Lord God, that we will see only what we produce through you, God. So we ask, Lord God, that you continue to just drive within us. This afternoon, as we celebrate this 100 years, we ask, Lord God, it just not be this time, just not for this portion of our lives, but Lord God, in everything that we do, let us continue to excel. Let us continue to show who you are. Let's continue, Lord God, to express, Lord God, your love, your determination to pull who we are through you, God. We ask, Lord God, that you touch everyone who's going to speak today and let them speak through you, Lord God, that this will just not be a ceremony done for this year. But, Lord God, the years to come, we will continue to see you and only you move within this community. In the mighty name of Jesus do we pray. Amen.
Please be seated. I'd now like to call Fourth Dimension to come forward as they lead us in a praise and worship. So you know we have some restrictions because of COVID, but there's never restriction in praising God. So we're going to bless you with some selections this afternoon, and as we come together, we pray that you will indeed be blessed. God is good.
All the time.
And all the time.
God is good.
We are here to celebrate this afternoon. So our first selection would be Eagle's Wings. and it will be led by Kima Willett. And if you notice, just worship with us this afternoon.
You are the same. You are the same. Yesterday, today, forever. Nobody is like you.
You never change.
You never change. Yesterday, today, forever. Nobody loves you like you.
In the house today,
you are the living God.
Do I have any worshipers in the house today?
You are the living God.
We serve a living God.
You are the living God.
Yes, He is. Yes, He is.
You are the living God.
Hey.
You are the living God.
God, because He's brought us all this way from 1920 to 2020, 100 years of educating the community. So we stand amazed at God's presence. He is indeed an amazing God. Amen.
Amen.
I don't want to feel like I'm in the house alone today. He is an amazing God. Amen.
Amazed in your presence.
Sing, 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 sing.
There is nothing you cannot do. I stand amazed in your presence. There is joy, peace, and hope. There's no one like you. There's no one like you in all the earth. There's no one like you, Jesus. There's no one like you. You do mighty things.
You do glorious things. You're a faithful God. Awesome is your name. You do mighty things. You do glorious things. You're a faithful God. Awesome is your name.
Lord, I stand amazed.
Stand amazed in your presence. There is nothing you cannot do.
Lord, I stand amazed.
Stand amazed in your presence. Stand amazed in your presence. no one like you. In all the earth, there's no one like you. Jesus, there's no one like you. You do mighty things. You do glorious things. You're a faithful God. Awesome is your name. You do mighty things. You do glorious things. You're a faithful God. Awesome is your name. You do mighty things. You do glorious things. You're a faithful God. Awesome is your name. You do mighty things. You do glorious things. You're a faithful God. Awesome is your name. You do mighty things. You do glorious things. You're a faithful God. Awesome is your name. You do mighty things. You do glorious things. You're a faithful God. Awesome is your name.
And at this time, I'm going to ask us all to stand as we take just a moment to remember Miss Ruth E. Thomas, dearly departed. I thank you. It is my pleasure to now welcome to the podium the president of the Alumni Network, Mrs. Elma V. Bradwith Curtis, class of 1989. You may be seated. I'm sorry.
Reverend Courtroy Jarvis, Commissioner Raquel Berry Benjamin, Superintendent Stefan Jurgen, Principal April Petrus, Past Principal Jeanette Smith Barry, distinguished guests, alumni, students, and friends of the Charlotte Amalia High School, good afternoon. On behalf of the Charlotte Amalia High School Alumni Network, I bring greetings to each of you and thank you for joining us, whether you do so virtually or in person, for this service of celebration as CAHS observes its centennial anniversary. 100 years of excellence to the children of the Virgin Islands, and the Alumni Network is honored to be a part of the celebration. The CAHS Alumni Network was formed to connect alumni and reunion classes to CAHS, to find ways for the organization to serve as a vehicle for graduates to support and offer assistance to our dear alma mater. COVID-19 has put a damper on our plans for the centennial celebration, so today we are especially excited about the execution of this worship service. I really want to thank Monique Richards and her hardworking committee for doing this. Thank you. CAHS has been at the heart of shaping the lives of so many in this community and abroad. And the CAHS Alumni Network would love to have all the graduates and friends of CAHS join us in our efforts to serve the blue and gold. Visit our website and become a dues-paying member as we continue to contribute to CAHS and prepare for the next century of education. So again, I say thank you for coming, thank you for joining us, and welcome.
It is now indeed my pleasure to welcome to do our musical selection for us, current ninth grader at the Charlotte Amalia High School, Mr. Kian Harrigan Thomas, will be doing You Raise Me Up.
When I am down and oh my soul so weary, when troubles come and my heart burdened be, and I am still and wait here in the silence until I'm
Thank you, Kian. Come over to the railing and take a bow, Kian. He was sitting from upstairs. Come on, Kian. Take a bow so that everyone can see you. Come a little further down. Come a little further down. There he is. Thank you so very much. And what a fitting introduction as we now invite our Insular Superintendent of the Virgin Islands Department of Education, St. Thomas, St. John District, hailing from the class of 1991, Dr. Stefan V. Jurgen.
I don't know if I will ever get used to this. If when you have on the mask, you can't put down your glasses because they fog up. So, pardon me. Good day, all. It is an honor for me to be here today. I bring you greetings from the Department of Education, where the Honorable Commissioner Raquel Berry Benjamin serves as Commissioner. Commissioner, stand and give the people a wave. So, full disclosure, my sister Monique Richard sent me, Pastor Jarvis, how are you this morning? This afternoon? It's good to see you. Good. Sister Richard sent me the program as a reminder on Friday of last week. And I noticed that next to everyone's name, there was their class. But next to my name, it didn't have a class. So I said, well, this is going to be the first thing I correct. But I see that Sister Richard corrected herself. And then I also looked next to my classmate, April Petras, and see that she didn't have her year printed there either. And then I looked down a little further to my classmate, Merida Gunt, and see that her name, we were the only three like that didn't have the names printed, the year printed next to our name. So I'm happy that, I know that you did that on purpose, because I heard you mention earlier something about the best class, but I just know that if you're so much the best class, why did you have to go to the class of 91 to get all of these? So we are the most populated class here today, the class of 1991. And that is something, that is a fight that will forever be. The best class, every individual that attended the Charlotte Amalia High School, they had the best class. So it's an argument I really try to stay out of. Mr. Calward, best class. Bradwitt, best class. See, there in the back, you don't want to start. That's a war right there. See? So first, I am really thankful for this ceremony. It appears to be timely. Not that in the 100 years, but also to be able to just honor one of our just educational giants in this community, Ms. Ruth E. Thomas. After when I became principal of the Charlotte Amalia High School some years ago, one of the things that Ms. Howell and Ms. Smith shared with me is that you have to make contact with Ms. Ruth E. Thomas. You have, out of respect, not that it's her school or anything, you know, but the school meant so much to her. She was so vocal about the advancement of the Charlotte Amalia High School. As a sign of respect, you have to make contact with Ms. Ruth E. Thomas. So when I called Ms. Thomas, the first thing she said to me is, young man, I was expecting this call. And we got to talking for a long time. And in the end, I said, Ms. Thomas, is there anything you want me to know? Anything you think I should know in serving as principal? And she said, Mr. Jurgen, there are two jobs that are of utmost importance in the Virgin Islands. The governor and the principal of the Charlotte Amalia High School. She said they go hand in hand. She said, with the exception of the airport, there isn't a place that is as populated on a day-to-day basis, and you have got to welcome all of those people to the campus daily. You've got to be responsible for them learning something and teaching them values. And then at the end of the day, you've got to send them back home safely. That's your charge. And that's not an easy thing to do. And it's a job that I took seriously. She went on to tell me that it's a job that you cannot do by yourself. And you rely on your faith, and you ask God for guidance to take you through. And that's exactly how I was successful in my tenure as principal, though short-lived, at the Sharon Amalia High School. You know, a few years ago, when my class, the CHS class of 1991, were celebrating our 20th anniversary, CHS was 90, right? And so I remember at that program in the auditorium giving some remarks, and I was fired up, and I shared with everyone, you know, my love for CHS. And I was so specific as to telling them that my special seat in the auditorium was row OC22. And, you know, everything about that I loved about CHS. Well, I know that those remarks landed me. I was an assistant principal at the Adelita Cancrang Junior High School at the time. And I know that those remarks landed me right there the following September as an assistant principal. And then when CAHS made 95 in 2015, you know, I served as principal. And I remember in my remarks again, we were planning for 2020. And most of my remarks at the graduation were about the plans that we have to push our school into the second century, and all of the support that was needed to celebrate and acknowledge the centennial. And so, as I stand here today as superintendent at the 100th anniversary of CAHS, my tenure as superintendent started in a way that I just did not expect, because one of the first things that I've had to do is to make the decision to pretty much condemn the large parts of CAHS. And so, to me, things have come just full circle. And this is certainly not where we expected or hoped this celebration would be, but it is still so important to celebrate for 100 years the Sharon Amalia High School has done us right, has served us well, and has helped us to become the men and the women that we are in many professions in the U.S. Virgin Islands and abroad. And so, yes, we are always bonded when you go off island and you see that so many individuals pass through those same halls of CHS. And so now, our efforts really are focused on what the new Charlotte Amalia High School is going to look like. And that's something that all of you have a hand in. All of you have an input, have an opportunity to give some input for what you want our school to look like. We have an awesome team at the Department of Education that really has been doing the groundwork in laying out what the facility is going to look like, the programs it's going to serve, and I encourage each and every one of you to be a part of that in some way, shape, form, or fashion. Also, one of the things that I've always loved about CAHS is you just can't beat the giving, especially to good causes. And so I encourage you again to support your school, support those that are in the school presently through the use of fundraising, so that we can give scholarships to those that need to go after college. It's one of the best things that we can do with our time here on earth. But the Charlotte Amalia High School, I have many, many stories about CHS, and I just want to share one at this time. We were preparing for the Battle of the Bands, and the Battle of the Bands was like the most popular thing that every child, parent, everyone wanted to attend to. Well, you know, you have to order your uniforms and all of the props and all of those things. We were waiting in the post office for all of the items to come in. The items never came. So the night before, so we said they're going to come the morning of the event, the Saturday. They ran to the post office, checked the post office with full anticipation that everything is going to be there. Nothing was there. So we were down and out. So we thought, but a few individuals indicated that, you know what? If we check the time, it's still early. We could catch a flight to New York now, and we could go and shop, and we could be back by 5 o'clock this afternoon. And as crazy as that sounds, that's exactly what we did. We put some people on a plane, and they went to New York under Georgia Francis's leadership that Saturday morning of Battle of the Bands. And when the plane landed, the battle had already started. No one knew why we were delayed, but all hands were on deck to make sure that every child had something to go out there. And, you know, I don't know if you've ever been a part of anything, but when you prepare and you have your things in order and things don't happen according to plan, you have you could end up being frazzled, right, and getting thrown off of your game. But those children were able to go out there with the full support of the school because everyone came together to make sure that that thing happened. And it just speaks to the spirit of the heart of when the people come together to support our children, great things happen. So in these next couple of years, as we continue to transform the Department of Education, we ask for your full support, your patience, and your understanding, and we ask that you be a part of the process along the way. Thank you. Have a good day.
Thank you very much, Dr. Jurgen. We'd now like to call on Mr. Jaquan Richards, class of 2019. To bless us with a musical selection.
Thank you.
Glory to God. Thank you, Jaquan, for blessing us. Thank you, Lord. We just want to thank you, Lord. Such beautiful music. God bless you. It is now my distinct pleasure to welcome the principal of the Charlotte Amalia High School, Ms. April Pretras, class of 1991, to give us a brief history of our beloved alma mater.
Good afternoon. Protocol having been established. It is such an honor for me to stand here as principal of my alma mater to share some of the history of our school. 100 years of rich, interesting, and captivating history encapsulate our illustrious Charlotte Amalia High School, known in the 1920s as the St. Thomas Junior High School, or the High School of St. Thomas. The doors were opened on August 9, 1980, as the first public school in the territory, with Stella M. Tate, a professor at the University of Puerto Rico, as its first principal. The school was often referred to as high school. However, the class of 1932, through the Reflector, the school's newspaper, eloquently let the community know that the official name of the institution was Charlotte Amalia, named after Charlotte Amalia of Denmark and Norway and wife of King Christian V and the capital of the United States Virgin Islands. A thorough understanding of the history of CAHS would include what was happening with the educational system in that era and also what occurred 3 years prior with the changing of the flag in 1917, indicating the transition from Danish rule to our becoming a United States territory. The educational system wasn't as we know it now, and for the next couple of years, it would be under construction to form a similar system that we have today. Through it all, CAHS played an integral part in the transformation of the Virgin Islands educational system as it transitioned from being a junior high school, grades 7 through 9 in 1920, to the addition of grade 10 in 1921, to eventually becoming a senior high school, grades 9 through 12 in 1965. In its early years, CAHS occupied the western building next to the Dutch Reformed Church on Commander Garda and had an enrollment of 75 students before growing to 120 students by the end of that year. Because of its mountain population and because of concerns concerning naval operations, CAHS bounced back and forth between the Commander Garda building and the Marine Barracks, now the VI Legislature, until 1955. Groundbreaking for the new Charlotte Amalia High School occurred in the spring of 1953 at 8 and 9 Sugar Estate Road on the now Alton Adams Drive, its current location. On April 17, 1955, the dedication of the new CAHS took place and the doors opened officially on April 18, 1955. For 65 years, the buildings have stood majestically at its current site. From its inception, Charlotte Amalia High School has exhibited nothing but excellence, producing outstanding students. On June 26, 1931, the first four graduates received their diplomas. Those graduates were Enid Marie Barr, Albert Comisiong, whose wife, Mrs. Doris Proudfoot Comisiong, we believe is our eldest living alumna today at the age of 101. In addition to Enid Barr and Albert Comisiong, Ellen Holtz and Eric Alexander Smith were the first high school graduates. Enid M. Barr would be the first CAHS graduate to receive a scholarship from the U.S. Department of Interior to continue her studies at Howard University. And a year later, a second scholarship would take her to Hampton Institute. The class of 1935 included students from St. Croix on scholarship to complete their studies at CAHS. The valedictorian of the class of 1935, as well as the class president, vice president of the Quill and Scroll Honor Society, and lead student editor of the Reflector was Melvin H. Evans, who would later become the last appointed and first elected governor of the Virgin Islands. Interestingly, two more CAHS graduates will go on and become future governors of the U.S. Virgin Islands, Charles W. Turnbull, class of 1952, and Roy Lester Schneider, class of 1957. And we are going to claim our current governor, Albert Bryan Jr., who attended CAHS for 2 years. We also had two CAHS graduates to become lieutenant governors of these Virgin Islands, Osbert Potter, class of 1974, and our current lieutenant governor, Tregenza Roach, class of 1977. Excuse me, Osbert Potter was class of 1974, and our lieutenant governor is class of 1977. The class of 1952 would be the first class to have members serve at the helm in each branch of government. In addition to Governor Turnbull, Elmo D. Roebuck, the class valedictorian, was a Virgin Islands senator, and Vern Hodge, the class salutatorian, served as presiding judge in the territorial court. Because of time constraints and the extensive history of our beloved Charlotte Amalia High School, this presentation provides just a snippet into its 100-year history. However, before I close, I would like to leave you with a few interesting facts. In 1932, the class of 1934, in their sophomore year, started the school's newspaper, The Reflector, thanks to J. Antonio Jarvis. 88 years after it was first produced, I can proudly say The Reflector is still in production today. It was also in 1932 when our beloved school song, Our Alma Mater, made its debut, having been written by Arthur Benjamin, Larry Benjamin's father, and Hugh Smith, both of whom were sophomores at the time. CAHS has had 25 principals in its 100-year history, with Jeanette Smith Barry and the late Ruth E. Thomas serving the longest at 13 years. Gold and blue showed up in the tassels for the class of 1937, foreshadowing what would become the school official colors. The class of 1947 added a new event to school activities known as Inaugural Night, which would later become known as Introductory Night, still a popular senior class ritual up to last year. The mighty Chicken Hawk would be selected as the school mascot in 1950. Eldra Thomas, class of 1950, would become the first alumna to earn the title of Carnival Queen. And in 1958, Eva Dunlap would become the first CAHS senior to reign as Virgin Islands Carnival Queen. In Carnival's history, CAHS have reigned over Carnival for the longest period of consecutive years, 1969 through 1975, 1983 through 1991, and 1999 through 2017. The class of 1961 would be the first class to host Honors Night. On September 8, 1961, a sea of blue and blue would flow through the gates of CAHS as students proudly wore their new blue and blue school uniform for the first time. The quest for accreditation of CAHS began in 1963 and was successfully completed in 1964. And lastly, in 1966, the motto, "To Excel Always," was formally adopted. Our outstanding alumni have made and continue to make noteworthy contributions in communities around the globe. The positive impact of the mighty, mighty Chicken Hawks give credence to the most popular cheerleading chant. Hey, you know the story. The whole wide world is Hawks territory. Even as our school buildings are now slated for demolition and a new structure is to be built, I have no doubt that the brilliant minds in our current students and in future students, our alumni, Hawks around the world, and our generous supporters and friends would proudly continue to carry the torch of excellence, living up to our school's motto, "To Excel Always." Unquestionably, CAHS is the best high school in the territory. Long live our distinguished and stellar alma mater, Charlotte Amalia High School. I would like to take this opportunity to thank Senator Myron Jackson for introducing a resolution to commemorate the centennial, and Senator Fred Gregory and Senator Saro, who are also sponsoring legislation to assist with centennial activities, and to all who have already made special contributions, monetary and otherwise. Because of the coronavirus, we are unable to congregate in large numbers, but we would still like to capture aspects of our celebration and record for posterity. A fund at the Community Foundation of the VI has been set up, and we invite alumnus, every community and business entity, to contribute at least $100, and feel free to add on as many zeros as you would like for the 100, so that we can, in the future, increase scholarships and improve and expand programs in continued growth and enhancement of this landmark institution. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Ms. Petras, for that journey down memory lane. We will now have the brother and sister dynamic duo, Malvern Gums, class of 95, and Marita Gums, class of 1991, to do a musical selection for us.
Good afternoon, church. Please feel free to worship with us this afternoon. As we are giving thanks, we're just going to minister in song. Because of who you are, we continue to give God the glory.
Before we continue, you know, good afternoon, church. You know, under normal circumstances, I would have told everyone that, you know, the class of 1995 is the best class that ever graced the halls of CAHS. But I would never say such a thing because we have so many people from the class of 91 here. So I wouldn't say such, and you know, I haven't sung with my older sister in so long. She will be the first to tell you that you learn to sing from me. So I'm just going to be the background vocalist this afternoon as she leads the way, and I hope you enjoy it.
Jehovah Nissi, your reign, Lord, your reign.
Thank you.
Thank you so very much. Because of who you are, Lord, we worship you. It is my pleasure to now introduce to you the pastor of this house, the pastor of the Memorial Moravian Church, the Reverend Dr. Courtroy Jarvis, who will bring us today's meditation. Reverend Jarvis.
Of the Alumni Association, indicating that you'd like to have this 100th anniversary service here at Memorial. How could we have said no? And I listened carefully this afternoon to all those who came before me. And one of the things I picked up is that each year was the best year. And so I don't know, you're going to have a challenge to determine finally which one was the best. It suggests to me that all the year groups were good. And so we give God thanks in a special way. 100th anniversary. And today we are celebrating not only with those of us here within the confines of the sanctuary, but persons are viewing this service all over the world. And so wherever you have someone who attended the Charlotte Amalia High School, wherever they live in the world, they are free to share and to join in this service. Continue to tell your story. Do not let anybody else shape your story. You are part of the story, and you need to control this story, to guide it, to speak it, to let others know how proud you are of the high school that shaped you, that molded you, that guided you, and have brought you to the place where you are today. Let us pray. O Lord and our God, we want to thank you, Lord, for the 100 years of this noble institution. We thank you, God, for all those who passed through the halls, those who taught, those who sat in the classrooms, and those who are now movers and shakers, not only in this territory, but throughout the world. We bless you for them. We bless you for this institution. And we pray, God, even as I stand in this place another time to deliver your word, help me, O God, to speak your word with faithfulness, with clarity, with authority, with passion, with wisdom, with humility, and with liberty. Bless your word, therefore, to our hearts, and may your name and your name alone be glorified. We pray this in the name of Jesus, who is the Christ, and all God's people say, amen. As I reflected and thought of the brief word that the organizers asked me to bring this afternoon, there's a text from Psalm 145 that kept coming to me all along. Psalm 145, verses 4 to 6. And this is what it says. One generation shall praise your works to another and shall declare your mighty acts. I will meditate on the glorious splendor of your majesty and on your wondrous works. Men shall speak of the might of your awesome acts, and I will declare your goodness. One generation shall praise your works to another. And as we celebrate today, we must never despise small beginnings. I heard the principal as she gave the brief historical review of the school, spoke of the time when there was only 75 students. Today you have hundreds of students. Thousands. Wow. So never despise small beginnings. 100 years of existence is a long time for any organization. When our forefathers in 1920 embarked upon the establishment of the Charlotte Amalia High School, they did not know what would have become of it. Their aim, I believe, was to seek higher education for the residents and citizens of this territory. They were mindful that for the advancement of a people, that one must reach higher and dig deeper. As pioneers, they wanted to leave a solid foundation for future generations to hold on to. You see, my brothers and sisters, we must not leave the place the same way that we met it. We must seek to build upon it and to improve it and make sure that each generation following, they continue to build upon that solid foundation. I was reading recently. In fact, I knew part of the story before, but recently I was reading about the Wright brothers. The Wright brothers were two Americans, Orville and Wilbur, who are largely credited with making the world's first successful airplane in 1903. The inventors and aviators achieved the first powered, sustained, and controlled aircraft flight in 1903. Orville, we are told, made the first successful flight covering 120 feet. Imagine that. 120 feet is just outside the church door, somewhere just about outside there. And they consider that to have been a tremendous achievement. The first flight was 120 feet, and it was completed in 12 seconds. And if you read anything of the history of aviation, you will always see this, the very first flight. And you know, this was after several attempts. So imagine some of the flights were just about 2 feet, 3 feet, and finally they got to 120 feet. They never gave up. And for me, this is important. They pursued their dreams. And today, airplanes can fly for upwards of 15 hours nonstop, much, and some of them even longer than that. And so, what this is saying to me is that each generation must learn and improve on the generation before it. We serve an awesome God, a God who surpasses all understanding. So the psalmist tells us in our text this afternoon, one generation shall praise your works to another and shall declare your mighty acts. I will meditate on the glorious splendor of your majesty and on your wondrous works. Men shall speak of the might of your awesome acts, and I will declare your greatness. I will declare your greatness. You know, whenever we celebrate an anniversary, we must do three basic things. Anytime, whatever anniversary it is, one, we must look back to the past. Two, we must examine the present. And three, we must look forward to the future. Look back to where we started, from whence we came. We must look at the challenges and the obstacles that were faced by those who were there in the beginning. But not only must we look back at them, but we must look to see how those challenges and obstacles. We must never give up trying. Never give up trying. And then we must look and examine the present. We must examine the present to see where we are in relation to where we started. We must evaluate ourselves at all times. We must create the atmosphere and environment for others to thrive and succeed. You know, there are some persons who, once they succeed, they don't care about anybody else. There are still some persons like that today. But I thank God for teachers, and I thank God that we are celebrating an educational institution. Because if teachers were content and tell themselves, I don't want any of my students to be as good as I am, you know what would happen? We would be regressing rather than progressing. Teachers here today would tell you that many of their students have reached higher heights than them. And that is good. And that's really teaching. We impart to our students so that they can improve themselves and even become better than us. Do not be afraid to share your knowledge and wisdom and understanding. We must make the way easier for others. So don't hold on to the knowledge. Share it. Why die with all the knowledge when somebody else can gain something? So we must examine the present. And the final thing we need to do is we must look to the future. We do not know what the future holds. I heard the insular superintendent saying that one of the first decisions I think he had to deal with or probably encountered was to deal with what is going to become of the present structures at the Charlotte Amalia High School. And he asks each of us to make our input. Am I right, Brother Stefan? Have an input so that the buildings or the school of the future would be even better than what it is today. And for me, this is important. We must look to the future with great anticipation and expectation. So we look to the past to see from whence we came. We examine the present to see what progress we have made. And we look forward to the future to inspire others for excellence. And so I say to you this afternoon, long live the Charlotte Amalia High School. May its future be greater than the past, and may it grow from strength to strength. I therefore challenge you to rise, and indeed to raise the standard higher. The Negro National Anthem helps us to tell our story. And this story for me is important as I conclude this brief message. It says, lift every voice and sing till earth and heaven ring. Ring with the harmonies of liberty. Let our rejoicing rise high as the listening skies. Let it resound as the rolling sea. Sing a song full of the faith that the dark past had taught us. Sing a song full of the hope that the present has brought us. Facing the rising sun of the new day begun, let us march on till victory is won. Stony the road we trod, bitter the chastening rod, felt in the days when hope unborn had died. Yet with a steady beat, have not our weary feet come to the place for which our fathers sighed. We have come over a way that with tears has been watered. We have come treading our path through the blood of the slaughtered, out from the gloomy past, till now we stand at last where the white gleam of our bright star is cast. And the anthem concludes this way. God of our weary years, God of our silent tears, thou who hast brought us thus far on the way, thou who hast by thy might led us into the light, keep us forever in the path, we pray. Lest our feet stray from the places, our God, where we met thee. Lest our hearts, drunk from the wine of the world, we forget thee. Shadowed beneath thy hand, may we forever stand true to our God, true to our native land. God bless you, my brothers and sisters, and again, long live the Charlotte Amalia High School. Amen.
Indeed, Reverend Jarvis, you truly inspired and blessed us this afternoon. Long live the Charlotte Amalia High School. Amen. Amen. We will now call on Swans in the Lake under the direction of Mr. Michael Lake, class of 1984. Right, Mr. Lake? Oh, 85. To do the presentation for us today, we have current members of the Charlotte Amalia High School as well as alumni participating this afternoon. Only Akira, okay, Akira.
think of you every step of the way.
And I will always love you. I will always love you. I hope life treats you kind, and I hope you have all you've dreamed of, and I wish you joy and happiness, but above all this, I wish you
Thank you, Mr. Lake, and Swans on the Lake. Well, now I'd like to ask Mr. Levi Farrell, class of 1982, to come and offer a prayer on behalf of the CAHS administration, teachers, staff, students, and alumni.
Good afternoon, everyone. Bless you, Commissioner. You good? Before I pray, I got this program today. Well, I want to do something right quick. I would like to really acknowledge Swans on the Lake. That was beautiful. That was beautiful. That was beautiful. I received this program as I came in. I was told to come and pray. I didn't know what I was going to pray for. And I came and I see to pray for the CHS administrators, teachers, staff, students, and alumni. God has a way how he speaks to me. So as I looked at this, I'm going to tell you what I heard first as I looked at it, what he spoke into my spirit, because I'm going to pray in accordance with what I saw. I see administrators, teachers, staff, students, and alumni. With the administrators representing the King, Christ, the teachers representing the apostles, the staff representing the deacons, the students representing disciples, and then those of us who have matriculated from this fantastic institution, we then become the evangelists. So in accordance with that manner, that is how I will pray. And before I pray, if I may just say this again, Christ being the chief cornerstone taught the apostles who could not be bothered with certain things and got deacons to do the work. And then while the deacons are doing what they're supposed to do, the apostles were the example to the disciples. And after they had made disciples, then the disciples were given a commission to go into all the world. So that is how I shall pray. If you can bow your heads with me as we give God praise. Father, in the matchless name of Jesus Christ, we declare today that you are indeed omnipotent, and there is none beside you, O God. You are indeed Alpha and Omega. You are indeed the first and the last. You are worthy to be praised. Before we ask you for anything, we just stop and we worship you, because you're the one that gave us breath. Every one of us sitting in these pews this day, every one of us that are on this island that is breathing, we are breathing not of our own, but by your divine permission. So God, we stop and we thank you, because had it not been for your grace and for your mercy, none of us would be on the upside of earth this day. Father, first, I lift up this day unto you the administrators of Charlotte Amalie High School, the principal, the assistant principals. God, I pray that they function in unity as you and your Son Jesus Christ and Holy Spirit have functioned as one, always, never having a disagreement, never having a dispute, O God. Men may say that that is impossible, but your word says, in you are all things possible. Principal of CAHS, touch the administrators of CAHS, for them to sit down, O God, around a table and discuss the course that you have set in the kingdom of heaven for the function of CAHS, and it functions in accordance with that plan. God, I speak unity to the hearts of each one of them, breast to breast, heart to heart. There be no ism and there be no schism, there be no strife, mutiny. One trying to overtake the other, one trying to get another's position or title, O God, but each one lifting up the other, Father God, not for the good of themselves, but for the good of the student body, that this school, CAHS, would be an example, not just in St. Thomas, not just in the territory, not just in the Caribbean, but around the world, of what excellence looks like, of what excellence ought to be. I thank you that they are governed by your Spirit, Father. Then, God, I lift up the teachers. God, according to your word, the apostles, they sat at the feet of Jesus Christ, and they heard what Christ said, and then they went out and they taught in accordance. I thank you that when the faculty has a meeting and the administration brings across the plan, Father God, we may not always agree, Father, but I thank you that where we do not agree, instead of there being mayhem, God, there will be suggestions for how is a better way to get the vision across, to get the mandate across, to accomplish the task that has been set in the hearts of the people by you. God, I thank you that every teacher in the school is skilled, is dedicated to their craft. They have not taken the job just because they have 3 months off in the summer and 2 weeks off in Christmas time, but they are totally dedicated to teach, for there's no other noble occupation in all the land but to mold and to shape a young mind, to transform a mind, to educate, O God, to create the next generation to be better than the generation standing before, O God. I thank you that they have a heart to see the better of those who are coming, to see the best in them that are coming, to pull what is on the inside out, that which you have deposited, they draw out of them in the name of Jesus. And I thank you that they do it with excellence, not by pulling down, not by tearing down by words of disparagement, but by words of encouragement and upliftment, that the children will truly hear and desire to be like them. I thank you for the deacons, O God, the staff that will take, they will do the work, Father. They get no glory, Father. For many times we think and teachers and administrators and the staff go behind the scene. Those that are in the office, those that are paraprofessionals, those that are doing the things behind the scene that no one knows about. Many times, O God, they get no credit, but according to your word, the thing that is not comely, is the thing that we give more attention to. So I thank you that without the staff, there can be no function in schools in the name of Jesus. So we honor them this day, Father, for you've placed them strategically in the school, in various subject areas and grades, to assist in the task of educating and molding, being an assistant to the teacher's father. I thank you that you do it willingly and cheerfully with a joyful heart, for you said in your word that you love a cheerful giver. And you're not talking about money only, for in each one of them you have given a gift. Their gift may not be as recognized as a teacher, but God, it is recognized in you. And I thank you that to those who will do it behind the scenes without seeking credit, you will credit them openly and have them recognized openly, Father. In the name of Jesus Christ, I come against accidents and incidences concerning them, Father, that they do their jobs wholeheartedly and diligently, that they bring something to the table, that they not have a parasitic mind, but they have a mind to contribute in the name of Jesus Christ. Then, Father, I lift up the students who are the disciples, the followers. God, I lift up in the name of Jesus those that are in CAHS that right now they're learning remotely. So I pray for discipline. Discipline as they go down a path that we have never tried before, that they have the discipline and the mindset to sit and be attentive to what is being explained to them via the computer or the iPad or whatever is their means of learning, Father. I thank you that they take these times seriously and they recognize that in trying to cheat, they're not cheating anyone but themselves. I thank you that, Father God, even though they're not being seen in the natural, they have a desire to excel, God. They have dreams and they have the visions. That which you gave them when you sent them from heaven, oh God, birthed in their mother's womb to be placed in the earth. I thank you that purpose that you placed inside of them comes to pass. The senators, the doctors, oh God, the attorneys, oh God, we esteem those occupations highly. But I thank you for those who just work in a jewelry store, Father God, at a gas station, Father God, at public works or in a septic, Father, for every occupation is critical in this hour. I thank you that they have a mind to be contributors to our society, so they take their education seriously, for they are the shakers and the movers of the next generation, changing the landscape of the earth from how it is to how it shall be, and how you shall find it when Christ returns. I thank you that out of the window, out of their minds, God, goes idleness and thoughts of evil, and how to use their talents for bad and not for good. I thank you that they have no taste for that type of a lifestyle, but they purpose it with this isolation that they're in. They learn who they are, and they strive to be the best of who they are, because it is you who created them to be excellent. And then, Father, in the name of Jesus, I lift up every alumni who's an evangelist. We are called, an evangelist is called to represent your kingdom. And every alumni is called to represent CAHS with distinction and with pride. We stand boldly declaring the school from which we graduated from. God, I pray for a spirit of boldness, yet humility, strength, yet meekness. Be prideful, O God, but yet be thankful unto you. For you're the one that caused every one of us that have graduated to have graduated from the school, Father. And finally, Father, she's not recognized on this paper. But CHS cannot stand without ultimate leadership. Christ, listen to you, God the Father, and the administrators and the teachers, the staff and the students and alumni must take their lead from the commissioner. So God, this day I lift up the commissioner of this territory, and I thank you that you would speak to her on the job, on her way to work, on her way home. I thank you that you protect her in her going out and in her coming in and her lying down and in her rising up. Father, I thank you that you give her creative ideas to take the department, to cause the department to rise to a level and a standard never experienced before, that she cannot take any credit for it, but she can only say, had it not been for God, nothing could be accomplished. Father, at the end of the day, let it be said from every level that I just call out unto you, from their lips be said, to you, Father, and to you alone be the glory and the honor. In Jesus' name, amen.
Thank you so much, Mr. Levi Farrell. Before I call on our next speaker, I'd like to introduce or to recognize members of the Golden Anniversary Class who are worshiping with us today, the class of 1970. Please stand. We thank you for choosing to come as a class to worship in this most important service. And I couldn't go without recognizing you because you look so wonderful. God bless you. The next speaker from the class of 1961. So he is indeed from the oldest class represented today. So I ask you to join me in welcoming CHS Wall of Famer, Mr. Edward Tanny Thomas.
Reverend Dr. Jarvis, present and past leadership of the Charlemagne High School, I greet you on this first Sunday in Advent in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. I am honored to say a few words at the historic celebration of the 100th anniversary of my alma mater. Since I'm the oldest one here, my alma mater. I am a proud alumnus of the graduating class of 1961, and my reunion class is poised to celebrate our 60th year with activities in the coming year, 2021. There are two issues with being the last person to speak. The bad part is that everybody else has already said what you wanted to say. The good part is you can then speak for 2 minutes and sit down. However, the story of Charlotte Amalia High School should be repeated over and over again from different perspectives. And so this afternoon, I'm going to give you the perspective of those of us who entered Charlotte Amalia High School a long, long time ago. In 1955, we arrived at Charlotte Amalia High School from different parochial, public, and private institutions. As a matter of fact, we were the first group of seventh graders to continue our education at the newly built CAHS campus, which housed students in grades 7 through 12. The curriculum for us at that time was extensive, and we were privileged to be taught by so many dedicated, outstanding educators. And I'm going to list all of them. English by Mrs. Barbara Ambrose, Mrs. Inez Harvey, Mrs. Vitalio Wallace, Mr. Elmo D. Roebuck, and Dr. Ruth E. Thomas. Mathematics by Mrs. Genevieve Hodge Rogers, Mr. Elmo Adams Sr., Mr. Amadeo Francis, and Ms. Eudora Ken. Science by Ms. Agnes Millen, Mrs. Mary Klassen, Ms. Beryl Simmons, Mr. Osborne Harvey, and Ms. Doris Monsanto. Music by Ms. Lillian Benjamin and Ms. Agatha Canfield. Band by Mr. Herman Wallace. Social studies by Dr. Charles W. Turnbull, Mr. Vernon Callwood, Mr. Angel Callwood, and Mr. Stuart Martin. Business by Mr. Juanito Barry and Mrs. Hilda Lewis Joyce. Drama by Mr. Bill Swan. Home economics by Mrs. Elizabeth Michael, Mrs. Kathleen Lashley Rogers, Mrs. Dixie Lee Gillies, and Mrs. Genevieve Lois Lima. Physical education by Mrs. Lucia David, Mr. Vernon Scipio, and Mr. Sigurd Peterson. Industrial Arts by Mr. Austin Babe Monsanto, Mrs. Adina Ken, and Mr. Richard Callwood Sr. Vocational Shops by Mr. Kai Bao, Mechanics, Mr. David Monsanto, Carpentry, Mr. Kenneth Harrigan, Plumbing, and Mr. Carl Jensen and Mr. Orby Roebuck, Electricity. We fused all of these disciplines and graduated a strong representative class. CAHS provided us with a solid academic foundation, and upon graduation, a large percentage of us moved on to post-secondary studies. Many of us came back to St. Thomas and assumed positions in education, government, private industry, and commerce. We would like to extend halos and heartfelt gratitudes to former Governor Charles W. Turnbull, Mrs. Genevieve Hodge Rogers, Mrs. Hilda Lewis Joyce, and Mr. Vern Callwood, who are the only four of all those teachers that I listed before alive to witness and share in this awesome centennial celebration. One more fact, and Principal April Petrus beat me to the punch. Our class of 1961 holds the distinction of approving an official school uniform of blue and blue, which was first worn by the incoming class of 1962 and is still in effect today. End of discussion. Finally, in 2011, the leadership of the school created a wall of fame which recognizes CAHS graduates who had excelled in various professions and have made significant contributions to the quality of life in these Virgin Islands. I was selected to be one of the persons whose name appears on that wall, and I am indeed humbled by that recognition. I know my sister, Janet Smith, past president, principal, is also on the wall. As I close, permit me to salute current CAHS principal, April Petrus, and alumni network representative, Elmer Brathwaite Curtis, for their roles in organizing this celebration. Many thanks to everyone from this proud Chicken Hawk. Thank you.
You know, I give props to Brother Thomas, Brother Tani as we call him, because he is in fact the oldest alumni here today. So yes, Brother Tani, your class is indeed the best class. Well, my family, my Chicken Hawk family, you know that they say every good thing must come to an end. But just before we end, it is my distinct pleasure to welcome our very own Mr. L.J. Brathwaite to do some selections for us on the steel pan. And he is a member of the class of 2017. I'm so proud of this young man. I call him my nephew. Thank you. Indeed, it is a great day to give thanks, and we will call on Ms. Skelton, Vice President of the CAHS Alumni Network, to share those thanks.
Good evening. We acknowledge the presence of the Almighty God and His goodness to us. We praise Him as the God from whom all blessings flow. We pause now to acknowledge the contribution of the chairperson of today's activity, Mrs. Monique Richards, and all her supportive subcommittee members. Job well done, Team Monique. We are pleased to extend our profound thanks to Reverend Corduroy Jarvis and the board of the Memorial Moravian Church. This beautifully decorated edifice is the appropriate setting for today's commemorative service. Pastor Corduroy, we thank you for your kind words, and we intend for 100 years and more that CAHS will continue to produce trailblazers in this community and the world over. Mr. Lawrence Ramdasingh, we appreciate all of the hard work you put in for the smooth running of today's event. Master Technician, Mr. Aaron Plaskett, we thank you immensely for your service. Ushers, you were fabulous. You made the event all too easy. I also must extend a great, big, melodious thank you to the musicians who were here today to accompany the performers. Yes. The musical selections were oh so soothing to one's soul. The brother and sister team of Merida and Malvern left us begging silently for an encore. My all-time favorite CAHS all-female team, Swans on the Lake, and my good friend, their director, Mr. Michael Lee, you never disappoint. And today was no different. Kian Harrigan Thomas and Jaquan Richards sure let us know that the classes of 2019 and 2024 doesn't half step. Then, all of us share you as our nephew, LJ, but you know how I feel about you. It's nuff nuff love all the time, and you continue to make all of us proud. We see a great big future ahead of you, so we thank you for stopping by today. All of the musicians, in fact, were awesome, so we thank you from the bottom of our hearts for your contributions. Dr. Stefan Jürgen, CAHS past principal and now our esteemed insular superintendent, we appreciate the thoughtful sentiments in your greeting. I must tell you, I had to chuckle about the Battle of the Band. You forget one part. There were so many of us who traveled there with our ironing boards and our iron. And even as people were getting ready to go out, the clothes were still hot on their backs. Thank you for those fond memories. My good friend April Petras, your historical perspective of a century of greatness forced many of us to pause and reflect. We are cognizant of the fact that we have amassed a century of amazing feats. Thousands and thousands of students have entered the gates of this adorable learning institution as timid hawklets, and they left as high-soaring hawks of prominence to soar the globe and establish their presence of authority wherever they touch down. Thank you, Principal Petrus, for an outstanding presentation. And yeah, the gym isn't there, but we all know. They know the story. We know the story. The whole wide world is Hawks territory. Wall of Famer, Mr. Edward Tanny Thomas of the class of 1961. You skillfully crafted remarks that were so timely and powerful. You have provided food for thought, not only for those of us listening today, but for generations to come. Please accept our thanks, Mr. Thomas. Mr. Levi Farrell, your prayers for the CAHS administration, faculty, staff, and students did not fall on deaf ears. If ever there was a time when we needed prayers, it's right now. Thank you for covering the Chicken Hawks family with such a powerful prayer. My heartfelt gratitude is extended to all those of you who joined us physically here in the church today. I especially want to thank Commissioner Barry Benjamin. We know you have a lot on your plate, and we thank you for fitting us into your busy schedule and being here to celebrate with us today. Past Principal, Ms. Smith, we thank you for coming as a representative for the Past Principals Association. Give our regards to all the others, plenty of whom we know are listening online. To all the other CAHS alums and your family, we thank you, and we love you. To those who joined us virtually, I tip my hat off to you. You're fitting us into a Sunday afternoon when you have so many other things you could do is truly appreciated. On behalf of President Elmer Curtis and the other members of the E-Board of the Alumni Association, who I'll ask to please stand now, all the members of the E-Board who are present with us today, please stand. We thank you for having the vision to pull this together and to have Monique, our brainchild, pull it off. We are proud of our legacy, and may the next century of excellence be one that will be admired by generations to come. May God bless the Charlotte Amalia High School, and may God bless us all.
I invite us all to stand as we close this service. Let us pray. Our Father and our God, we are indeed thankful that we have been a part of this celebration. God, you journeyed here with us. You tabernacled with us. And now, God, as we are about to dispersed to our various homes and communities, we pray that your Holy Spirit will accompany us in whatever we do. So, Lord, let your Holy Spirit go before us to guide us, behind us to protect us, above us to cover us, and beneath us to lift us. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with us all, now and forevermore. Amen.
Amen. As we depart the sanctuary, Four Dimension will take us out. But let me take this opportunity to say a special thank you to Mr. Uriel. Uriel, we sought him out to come and help us out this afternoon. So thank you so much. And Uriel, you're a class of 2018. Amen. So for all of us, we know that we are indeed a chosen generation. And so if you know this song as we depart the sanctuary, please join us.
A chosen generation called for to show his excellence. All I require for life God has given me, and I know who I am.
We are
a chosen generation called for to show his excellence. All I require for life God has given me. I know who I am. I know who God says I am. What he says I am. Where he says I'm at. I know who I am. I know who God says I am. What he says I am. Where he says I'm at. I know who I am.
I walk in power. I walk in miracles. I live a life of favor.
Cause I know who I am. I'm walking in power, I'm walking miracles, I live a life of favor, cause I know who I am.
Oh, 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 oh.
Oh. Generation
called for
to show his excellence.
All I require
for life God has given me. I know who I am. I know who God says I am. What he says I am.
Where he says I'm at.
I know who I am.
I know who God says I am.
What he says I am.
Where he says I'm at.
I know who I am.
I'm walking in power. I'm walking miracles. I live a life of favor.
Cause I know who I am.
I'm walking
in power. I'm walking miracles. I live a life of favor. Cause I know who I am.
Take a look at me, I'm a wonder. It doesn't matter what you see now. Can you see his glory?
Cause I know who I am.
Take a look at me, I'm a wonder. It doesn't matter what you see now. Can you see his glory?
Cause I know who I am.
Take a look and I wonder. It doesn't matter what you see now. Can you see his glory?
Cause I know who I am.
Take a look at me and I wonder. It doesn't matter what you see now. Can you see his glory?
Cause I know who I am.
Oh, 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 oh.
Oh.
I know who I am.
Oh, 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 oh,
I know.
Yeah.